Hello, welcome back to our Nugget course. For today, I will be installing Microsoft Identity Management Tools 2016. So I've got my lab, as you can see, it's Hyper-V, and this is the server. Just need to make sure I've got all the NICs ready. I've installed 2016 server, and I just need to connect the network card to is it internal to make sure we speak to our Domi controller. So starting our Domi controller, and as soon as that starts, we will start, you know, communicating and doing the 2016. So we start the server as well. And bring you up. Let's see, have a look what we have here. It's quite, let's just scale it. Taking time to boot up. So after that, we'll have a look at the prereq, what we need to be able to install the MIM 2016. And guess you have a cover domain controller, it's up and running. And I think it is, which is fine, it's 2012R2, single label domain. Yep. And what we will do basically, we will install SQL Server, and we will need .NET, and that should be the most. So we will start, for this course, we will start installing the Sync engine, and we will continue basically doing you know, the portal, password reset, and the certificate management at later basically, you know, courses or no series. So let's have a look. We got our server, and it is both are booting up. So as soon as the server is coming up, the 2016, we will just basically log on, and you know, you can see it's scaling up now. And then we will start doing the installation. The aim for this course is to walk you through all the MIM, you know, settings, configuration, and how that basically all the new improvements around 2016. So let me just log on to that server, and we'll show you what we need, and then we will go through the domain controller and join the domain. And let's have a look. Yeah, that one's up and running. This is our domain. Let's look onto the domain controller and making sure, just to show you what we have as a forest and function level. And if I can remember the password, that will be good. And so we just logged on to the server, and I just remember the password for our domain controller, and guess we just log on. And we go to the 2016, which is ready. And I do have my okay. The prereq, I think I copy them to my C drive. Here's MIM, and here's the MIM installation. So we can see the MIM suite, all the components. So I'm just going to run the sp- slash, and this is film still slash.html. And as I mentioned earlier, we will start with the basic, sync. Then we will do the portal, and later on we'll do the certificate management, and then we can go to the behold later on. So let's have a look what we have around the sync. So I've already installed SQL, because part of the prereq you need to have a SQL installation. So let me just run it and we'll see what else we need. So now welcome to the identity manage sync surface, next, okay, next, and you can see here the path if you want to change it, and you can see the tool. Let's have a look if we can pass or we require more. Now as you can see here, it's a local installation and a SQL instance using the default SQL instance, which I've already installed on that machine. Let me just show you, and you can see here the SQL installation. I've got 2014 SQL, and this is my SQL management, on the server. So minimize, next, service account. Now service account, we do require the machine to be basically, you can see there, a service account domain or local computer name. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to join the machine to the domain and use the domain service account. Or this is what you're supposed to do. Basically you're supposed to have service account part of the domain rather than a local installation. So let's we switch back to our domain controller, and I'm just going to create a service account to start with. I mean, it's the pain, because for our exercise we're only doing the sync service, and which means I'm going to create only one service account. Later on we will be utilizing the other component, which means we need more service accounts for each one of these components. So I'm just going to create, right click here, and new user, let's we call it SRV, and we call it mem. Okay, SRV underscore mem. And let's we just password never expire, and nobody can change the password, just to make sure. And we give it password. And later on you need to do, we will talk about best practice around service account, making sure we apply the right policies, nobody can log on with them, and they're supposed to be secured and all these stuff. But this is a test environment, okay? So minimize this. Assume we got communication here. Let me just go to that account. Where is that? 2016. And let's we just log on to here. And I'm gonna just join the, making sure join the domain. And so we can join the domain and continue with the work. So let's we just change that one to be part of the domain. And I'm gonna log on, see if there's any communication first of all to my domain. I give it, I think, an internal IP, but there's no DHCP. So let's we go and assign static IP address here, and I don't have DHCP, which means I'm using I want to be able to get an IP address. Okay, I think it's 254.1.2.168.1.2. Let's just make sure I got the right information. I think it was .2. Close it and see if that getting identified while we're waiting. Let's just go and check what we got here. It's a test environment. So let's have a look. ipconfig/all. And we'll see what we got. We got, yeah, dot, what's the DNS? 2, and the gateway is 1. Okay, so let's go back here and change the gateway to 1. And you can see there it's not seeing the gateway, so change that one to 1, and that should be fine. Close, and that should be fine here. As soon as I get validated, let's have a look, and we can join the domain and can continue. And assuming everything's fine, and then when we join the domain, we can utilize the service account as a domain service account rather than. Let's have a look, and okay to there. Okay, and you can see here I'm able now to communicate to that domain. So let me use an administrator account and password. And when we join the domain, it's a single label domain, which means non-rootable domain, just to clarify. Again, that was for test environment. A few videos around, you know, migration integration with single label domain if you are interested, and you can check it under our IT Landy Tech channel under how to. Yeah, it's taking a bit of time to, you know, retain some info either in or out, but we'll see what happens if it's quite busy. Hopefully it's not my machine running out of space. And now we join the domain. Okay, here, and reboot that machine. Just quick reboot. And let's have a look when this machine came up first. And as soon as that come up, let's be sign an option and then go other users, and I'm just gonna log on as an admin account to the domain, as you can see, and then we'll basically use the service account. We will rerun the setting again, and this time should be easier. Let's just see if we're gonna go full mode, and here we go. I'm just gonna go browse again to the main file, and it is here. Go again, run it. I've already logged on as an admin. And here we go. Okay, here, and as I mentioned earlier, it will be only the sync service. Run it again. Yes. Let's just close the rest. We will be installing the rest later on. And here we go. Yes, run setup.exe. It's a bit slow. And we will do the rest at later on. So the first thing is the sync service. Here we go. Welcome to Microsoft Identity Manager synchronization service. Next, accept. Next, if you want to change the location, you can change it here. Next, computer name, and so this is local installation. I've got already SQL installed. Next, the identity sync service evaluation is having trouble contacting the SQL server. Yep, we'll check, and if we again we need to make sure it has the right this SQL services running, so I'm just gonna go and check it and make sure it is running. Let's try again. Bug, next, and we'll check if the SQL service is running or not.